अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द यूनिट ऑन स्टीम टर्बाइन्स एंड स्टीम पावर प्लांट्स एंड लेट अस मूव ऑन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर प्लांट्स। सो इन बिफोर स्टार्टिंग हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर प्लांट्स देर आर सम टॉपिक्स विच वी हैव टू स्टडी and actually these topics that is hydroelectric turbines or you can call it hydraulic turbines, these will be discussed in detail in your 7th semester, but today we will study some of its topics as which is mentioned in your syllabus. It is classification, this introduction on hydroelectric power plants, classification of hydroelectric turbines. First, its principle and working, then it is classification of hydroelectric turbines, and second is principles of impulse and traction turbines, and then characteristics of hydroelectric turbines, selection of turbines, and governing of turbines. These topics are your syllabus, and we will discuss only these topics, which is suitable for your this topic that is hydroelectric power plants. So I hope you will also conduct my notes already sent to you, and this will be discussed in detail in your 7th semester, but this time we will discuss some of its topics which are very important on the subject point of view. First, let us move on what is hydroelectric turbine. So as I told you in steam turbine power plant is that steam thermal energy from the steam is utilized for the running of the turbines. That means thermal energy is converted into mechanical work, or you can say shaft work. But in hydroelectric turbines, hydro means water. That means the energy obtained by the shaft or the turbines are coming from the water. That means the energy of the water, which is potential energy, you can say water head, or pressure energy. There are three terms actually used. You can call it potential energy or water head. It is converted into mechanical energy of the shaft. Let us see a definition of here. Hydraulic turbines convert the potential energy of the water into shaft work, which in turn rotates the electric generator coupled to it in producing electric power. So this is the basic definition of what is hydroelectric, what are hydroelectric turbines. So here I have mentioned a word head. So it's a very important topic, what is head called in the turbine, hydroelectric turbines. Let us move on the note I have sent to you. It is figure 10.23. I have book here. Let us see on the book. It is 10.23. Let us see here. This is a you can see this is the full-fledged diagram, the system schematic diagram of this hydroelectric turbine. You can see it is at the top, it is a reservoir, and then it is connected with the pipe, a large pipe, it is called penstock, and it is finally connected with a nozzle, and then it is connected with the turbine, and there are at the outlet of the turbine there is a tail race, and the water coming from the reservoir, which is at the topmost which is that means topmost level of the reservoir, it's called a tail race, and the water level at the down level of the turbine, that means where the water coming from the this exit from the turbine is called a tail race. That means there are two races, head race and tail race. So a reservoir is called a head race, and the tail race is the water coming out from the turbine. So that means we have to discuss here what are heads. So here are gross head, frictional head, and net head. I will tell you in detail what is this. Gross head, it means the head to overall head. It is called the overall head here. It is denoted by H gross. It is the head from the top of the reservoir, water reservoir, to the tail race. Okay. So it is the head from the reservoir, from the tail race to head race. That's called a total gross head. And there is HF. It is called a frictional head. As you must have studied in your previous semesters, there are some losses in the pipe when fluid flows through it, and that is frictional loss. So that frictional loss is denoted by HF. So it is called a frictional loss, or you can say here frictional head. So this frictional loss is denoted by frictional head. It is as HF. So it is the losses occurred in the pipes or penstock pipes during the flowing of the water. So it is this. Then is another third head, that is net head. This net head is actually the head used for draining the turbine. So this net head is equal to gross head minus frictional head. Okay. So you remember always this formula. This net head is equal to gross head minus frictional head. And there is again formula for frictional head HF. It is some formula. It is equal to you can see from the your previous notes that HF, there is some formula for HF which it is equal to something that it may be in this. You it will be in my third semester where HF, there's a formula for HF. So this time I will only show you that what is the principle of working of the hydraulic turbines. So this is all about this hydraulic turbines, and now let us move on the next topic. It is types of turbines. So classification of turbines, or you can say types of turbine, classification of turbines. So there are various types of these turbines, or the classification of turbines has been done on the various parameters. First, it is according to the head and quantity of water. There are some technical terms used in this turbine system, hydraulic turbine system. One is head, as you know, as I told you what is head. Second is this discharge quantity of water. Then you can say second, it is technical name is water discharge. That means different turbines have different heads and different discharges. That discharge means it is the volume flow rate of water per second. Okay? So discharge means volume flow rate of water to the turbine. That means water input to the turbine. It is denoted in it is measured in this cubic meter per second, and this is called, it is called discharge. And head is the where from the water it head is here called a net head. Okay, so it is equal to gross head minus frictional head. So head is actually, it gives you the this gives you actual potential energy required to convert to move the turbine shaft. Okay, so according to the head and quantity of water available, so you can see here there this low head, there are low head turbines, and they are running from their head is from two range of head is 2 to 15 meter. So from 2 to 15 meter you can say it is a low head turbine, and for low head turbine the example is Kaplan or propeller turbine. You will discuss these things later, and maybe I will give assignment of these topics, what is Kaplan turbine, what is propeller turbine, and some other turbines. And also there is a medium head turbine. Their range is between 16 and 70 meter, and for Kaplan or Francis turbine are its example. So there is a height head turbine. You can see here it is range is 71 to 500 meter, and its example is Francis turbine or Pelton turbine. So there is a other on the base of head, there is other turbine, it is called a very high head turbine, and its range is greater than head is greater than 500 meter, and usually Pelton type of turbine comes in this range. So you can say Pelton turbine is actually it is a type of impulse type of turbines. So you can, from this discussion, I am coming on the conclusion that this impulse turbines are working on at high heads, and these reaction turbines are working at medium heads and low heads. Okay, so now there is another term, that is low discharge. So low discharge, that is Pelton turbines are working at low discharge but at high head, and medium discharge, Francis turbines are working at medium discharge, and high discharge, that is Kaplan turbines are working under high discharge. So let us move on the another type. The another type is classification is based on according to the nature of the originator. That means who is the inventor of the turbine, and the name of the turbine is given accordingly of that inventor. ठीक है, so जिसने turbine को create किया है, invent किया है, इस turbine को नाम उसी inventor के base पे दिया गया है. ठीक है, so Pelton turbine, it was invented by Lazar Allen Pelton, so it was given from USA, so it is given, that is why it is given name as Pelton turbine. And impulse turbine used for high head and low discharge. ये आपको मैंने पहले ही बोला है. So Francis turbine, it was given by James and Francis, ठीक है. And Kaplan turbine was given by Dr. Victor Kaplan. And Dairy's turbine is other. Dairy's turbine, you will see it later. This turbine, it is given by civil engineer Dairy's. And then another classification is based on according to the nature of the working on the blades. ठीक है. So आपको मैंने पहले बोला कि एक टर्बाइन में रनर होता है और उसके ऊपर ब्लेड्स होते हैं. ठीक है. रनर मीन्स ए व्हील ऑन विच देर आर ब्लेड्स. ठीक है. एंड देर आल्सो वाटर कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द पेनस्टॉक इज फर्स्ट फ्लो थ्रू द नोजल्स, देन नोजल्स, देन आफ्टर वाटर कमिंग फ्रॉम द नोजल्स विद हाई वेलोसिटी दे स्ट्राइक द ब्लेड्स एंड दैट दिस काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज formed there. So from the nozzles, when the water is flown with high velocity, then it gives energy, maximum motion to the turbine. So here, on the basis of this nature of working on blades, it has been divided into impulse turbine and direction turbine. ये आपने इसमें इसमें भी पढ़ा है, steam turbine system में भी पढ़ा है. What is impulse turbine, direction turbine, and what are its construction, and what are the difference in their design? ठीक है. So you can also study further these detail. What are the principles of principle and construction of impulse and direction turbine? But this time I will give you only one definition about both, that all the available head of water is converted into kinetic energy in a nozzle. ठीक है. impulse turbine में क्या होता है, all the available head of water, head means that is I told you that the head means the potential energy of water is converted into kinetic energy in a nozzle, for example Pelton turbine. And यहां पे आप देखोगे all the entrance of the runner, only at the entrance of the runner, entrance means inlet of the runner, only a part of potential energy is converted into kinetic energy and remaining into pressure energy, for example Francis turbine. So yahan pe jo bhi energy aapko nozzle mein jo bhi water nikalta hai, strike karta hai runner ko, it is whole energy utilized in for the formation of kinetic energy. But yahan pe kya hota hai, jo entrance hota hai runner ka, मीन्स टर्बाइन ब्लेड पे जो इस पे जो स्ट्राइक करता है, मतलब जो इस पे जो स्ट्राइक करता है स्टीम, दिस वाटर विच इज कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द नोजल्स इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड रिमेनिंग इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू प्रेशर एनर्जी. दैट मीन्स यहाँ पे बोथ, इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू बोथ पार्ट्स, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी and this pressure energy and kinetic energy for some Francis turbine. So you can see in details what is the difference between reaction and impulse turbine. So यहाँ पे मैंने briefly आपको बोला है. And this another difference between the two is that these impulse turbines are actually called high head turbines, and these are called low head turbines. And impulse turbine is example is this Pelton turbine, and here are various examples of this reaction turbines. So another this category of the hydraulic turbines, they are also this classified into on the basis of direction of flow of water. ठीक है. सो ऑन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ वाटर, सो देयर मे बी डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ वाटर. मेन द वाटर स्ट्राइक इज द रनर, इट देयर मे बी डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन. सपोज यहाँ पे आप देखोगे, सपोज दिस इज रनर एंड इन साइड द रनर देर इज अ शाफ्ट. ठीक है. सो इन साइड द रनर देर इज अ शाफ्ट. सो दिस शाफ्ट इज मे बी हॉरिजेंटल और दिस मे बी वर्टिकल. ओके, ये हॉरिजेंटल भी हो सकता है शाफ्ट और ये वर्टिकल भी हो सकता है. ठीक है. सो दिस सो इन साइड द रनर देर इज अ शाफ्ट. सो वेन द वाटर स्ट्राइक इज द रनर, दिस स्ट्राइकिंग आर इम्पेजमेंट ऑफ वाटर ऑन द रनर, इट मे बी हैव डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन, इट मे गो इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन. आइदर इट गोज अलॉन्ग द शाफ्ट एंड अलॉन्ग द एक्सिस, और इट गोज टेंजेंशियल टू द रनर, और इट गोज अलॉन्ग द रेडियल डायरेक्शन, मीन्स इट परपेंडिकुलर टू द axis of the shaft. So on the basis of that, these shafts are classified as the shaft axis denotes the axial direction, the direction of this flow along the radius of wheel denotes the radial direction, and the flow directed along the tangent of the wheel is denoted by is called a tangential direction. So sometimes there is a mixed flow. कि कभी मिक्सड फ्लो होता है, जो इनलेट और एग्जिट होता है टर्बाइन का, एक इनलेट पे हो सकता है एक्सल फ्लो होगा और इसके एग्जिट पे हो सकता है देयर विल बी रेडियल फ्लो. सो देन एट दैट टाइम देन दैट टर्बाइन इज कॉल्ड मिक्सड फ्लो टर्बाइन. ठीक है, सो टर्बाइन कैन बी क्लासिफाइड ऑन द डायरेक्शन फ्लो ऑफ वाटर. इट कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज एक्सल फ्लो टर्बाइन, रेडियल फ्लो टर्बाइन और मिक्सड फ्लो टर्बाइन, और इट कैन बी कॉल्ड टेंशन फ्लो टर्बाइन. ठीक है, सो वेन देयर, जब इन तीनों में से, चारों में से कोई फ्लो नहीं होगा, there will be some other direction, that means neither it is axial, neither it is radial, neither it is tangential, neither it is mixed. If there will be some angular position, then it is called angular flow direction. ठीक है, then so, but it is an angular direction, so with respect to the axis, then it may be called diagonal flow. उसको बोलते हैं उस time diagonal flow, जब कोई other direction होगी. ठीक है, so let us see, move on the table 10.1 on your note, what is written in table 1.10.1. यहाँ पे आप देखोगे व्हाट इज इट इज टेबल 10.1. सो हियर इन टेबल 1.1 इट इज बीन द फ्लो, इट शोज फ्लो डायरेक्शंस ऑफ वाटर टर्बाइन्स. दैट मींस फ्रेंसिस टर्बाइन, इट इज रेडियल, इनवर्ड फ्लो और मिक्स्ड फ्लो. सो ये जो फ्रेंसिस टर्बाइन होता है, ये रेडियल फ्लो भी होता है और मिक्स्ड फ्लो भी होता है. सो हियर इट इज रिटन इनवर्ड, मीन्स रेडियल इनवर्ड मीन्स मीन्स इन साइड द ब्लेड्स. ठीक है, और यहाँ पे पेल्टन टर्बाइन दैट इज टेंशन फ्लो, एंड इन प्रोपेलर एंड कैपलन टर्बाइन देयर इज एक्सल फ्लो, एंड इन डेट टर्बाइन देयर इज डायगोनल फ्लो. सो ऑन द बेस ऑफ फ्लो आई टोल्ड यू व्हाट आर द क्लासिफिकेशन. नाउ लेट्स ऑन द मूव अदर टाइप्स ऑफ दिस टर्बाइन्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द एक्सिस ऑफ टर्बाइन शाफ्ट. According to the axis of turbine shaft. So, as I told you, the shaft inside the runner, जो shaft होता है, it can be horizontal or it can be vertical. ठीक है, ये vertical भी हो सकता है, ये horizontal भी हो सकता है. It can move horizontal or it can move vertically. ठीक है, so on that basis, the Pelton wheel turbines have horizontal shafts and the other turbines besides the Pelton turbine, they have all vertical shafts. ठीक है, so on the base, according to the space speed, this is a very important parameter. What is space speed? जो space speed हम जो parameter use करते हैं hydraulic turbine में, this parameter is used for the design criteria. Before designing the turbine, we are using specific speed parameter. So it is used for the comparison of two turbines or for designing of a turbine. So यहाँ पे आप देखेंगे हम ये भी आप detail में पढ़ोगे 7th semester में. This specific speed of turbine, that is NS, it is noted by NS, is the speed of a geometrically similar turbine which produces 1 kilowatt power under 1 meter head, and it is given by NS is equal to N under root of P divided by HS power 5/4. What is N? N is equal to normal working speed in RPM, it's the working speed of the turbine. P is called power output, is called power output of turbine in kilowatt, and H is called net head in meter. ठीक है, so सो यहाँ पे भी फिर भी मैं यहाँ पे इसको रेड करूंगा व्हाट इज द स्पेस स्पीड. सो इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर फॉर द डिजाइन ऑफ द टर्बाइन एज इट इंक्लूड्स ऑल द थ्री बेसिक पैरामीटर्स दैट इज स्पीड, पावर एंड हेड ऑफ द टर्बाइन. सो लेट अस मूव ऑन द टेबल 10.2 पे आप देखोगे टेबल 10.2 में क्या लिखा है. यूर आपके नोट पे है ये टेबल 10.2. यस, यहाँ पे आप देखोगे व्हाट इज टेबल 10.2. इट शोज द टर्बाइन क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेस ऑफ स्पेसिफिक स्पीड. यहाँ पे आप देखोगे पेल्टन स्पेस ऊपर है स्पेस स्पीड, यहाँ पे फिर लिखा है रनर, व्हाट रनर टाइप मीन्स इट इज पेल्टन टाइप, फ्रांसिस टाइप और कैप्लान टाइप. सो स्लो स्पीड ऑन द बेस ऑफ, अगर स्पेसिफिक स्पीड स्लो होगी देन दिस विल बी द रेंज ऑफ दिस टर्बाइन. अगर मीडियम स्पीड स्पेस स्पीड होगी देन दिस विल बी द रेंज. अगर फास्ट स्पेस स्पीड पे हमें टर्बाइन बनाना होगा तो देन दिस विल द रेंज. ठीक है, सो इट गिव्स द रेंज ऑफ स्लो, मीडियम एंड फास्ट स्पेसिफिक स्पीड. ऑन दीज कंडीशंस वी कैन डिजाइन ए टर्बाइन. सो नाउ व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस स्पेस स्पीड? इट इज यूज्ड फॉर द डिजाइन, फॉर बिफोर डिजाइनिंग द टर्बाइन्स, एंड आर इट कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर द कंपेयरिंग ऑफ द टू टर्बाइन्स. सो इट इज द डिजाइन क्राइटेरिया, एंड यू विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल and when you will go further, when you further study the turbines. So this was space speed, and then another is here. This was all about this classification of turbines. So now there is a topic that is turbine size. Let us move on the table 10.3. What is table 10.3 here? It shows you table 10.3. It shows you sizes of various turbines. That is type of runner, Pelton, Francis, Kaplan, maximum speed, maximum head. ये range दिखाता है यहाँ पे, this is maximum head and maximum power कितना बनाता है इस range पे, maximum wheel diameter इस range पे कितना होना चाहिए and what is wheel यहाँ पे होता है runner, runner means wheel, उसका डायमीटर, स्पेसिफिक स्पीड का रेंज, ठीक है ना. सो एक्चुअली ये डिजाइन, इट इज अ टेबल फॉर द यूज ऑफ डिजाइन ऑफ टर्बाइन्स. इट आल्सो गिव्स द डिजाइन क्राइटेरिया फॉर द टेबल. इट इज एक्चुअली अ रिसर्च, ठीक है. सो एक्चुअली सो लेट अस मूव ऑन द दिस स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम ऑफ पेल्टन एंड फ्रेंचेस टर्बाइन, ठीक है. लेट अस मूव ऑन फिगर 10.24 and 10.28. So it is figure 10.24 and 10.28 on your notes. It gives the difference between Pelton wheel and Francis wheel. ठीक है. So let us move on that this figure 10.24. यहाँ पे आप देखोगे this is the Pelton wheel. So यहाँ पे आप देखोगे this is the runner. This is the inside, this is the shaft. These are blades. This is a nozzle. Inside the nozzle, this is overall nozzle. Inside nozzle, there's a spare and there's a deflector. And so, what is the function of spare and deflector? They are used for the governing of the turbines. ये अभी बाद में बोलूँगा what is governing. What is the governing? So, this spare and deflector inside the nozzle, these are used for the governing system of the turbines. So, and this splitter, you can see shape of the splitter. This is the inside of the bucket and there's a splitter. Splitter when the water goes inside this bucket and it is divided into two streams. Okay, so this water is divided into this. That's why it's called a splitter. So the velocity angle is जो भी है ये आपको science में पढ़ना है, यहाँ पे mathematical में कुछ नहीं पढ़ना है. So let us move on the figure. It is another figure for the Francis turbine. यहाँ पे this is the turbine showing multiple nozzles. Okay, this is showing multiple 1, 2, 3. This is a multiple nozzle and first figure was showing one nozzle. So let us move on the Francis turbine. It is actually all about impulse turbine. Let us move on the Francis turbine. Francis turbine is a first example in reaction turbines. So यहाँ पे आप देखोगे what is the Francis turbine. This is the view of the Francis turbine. There is scroll casing. This outer covering is called scroll casing. Guide vanes यहाँ पे होते हैं इसको. There's a guide vanes on the runner. Or this is in inlet. And there are other parts of the draw. एक चीज यहाँ पे extra होता है इसमें रिएक्शन टर्बाइन में, इट इज जो इसका आउटलेट होता है, इट इज कनेक्टेड विद टू ड्राफ्ट ट्यूब. ओके, सो व्हाट इज ऑफ द व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द ड्राफ्ट टू से होता है फ्लो फिर वाटर आगे किसमें, रिवर में. So yeah, you can say tail race mein. So what is the function of drop two? It's, you can see here, it has a varying cross section. That is increasing enlarged cross section. So that means the water coming out from the exit of the turbine moves with high velocity. So agar ye high velocity se move karegi exit pe, then it can their velocity, then it is a kinetic energy will be wasted when it moves to the tail race. So to save this kinetic energy, we are inserting a drop two with the exit of the turbine. So what is the function of drop two? Jab iska cross section increasing hoga, so kinetic energy will be converted into potential energy. Then in that case you can save the kinetic energy by converting the kinetic velocity by reducing the velocity and by converting the kinetic energy into potential energy before entering the water into the tail race. Okay, so there are different you can see what is the difference between these all impulse turbine, reaction turbine, Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, Francis turbine and Pelton turbine. So this will be your assignment, so I will not discuss these things here. So let us move on. Before moving on the further topic, let us make another video for that topic. So it will be now for bigger MB. So okay, wait for the next video.